During this meeting, I am going to summarize the concept which we have discussed so far in chapter number 6, which is about the motivation. So let's start our consolidated slides for this meeting. Okay, the fundamental question which we have started earlier, that why are some employees more motivated than others? So this diagram can explain if the employees are very clear that what kind of the effort lead to the performance, and that performance is leading to the outcome, the desirable outcomes, and that outcome that desirable by the employee, then the employees are more motivated. And if there are specific and difficult assigned goal in the organization, and on the basis of that they are basically setting a difficult goal for them, difficult but achievable goal for themselves, and if their outcomes ratios, input ratios are equal to the outcome and input ratios of the other employees or reference points for them who are working in the organization, and the work by itself is intrinsically motivated for them, that they're enjoying their work, so they are putting more effort in the organization, and they are more motivated in the organization. And vice versa, if they lack self-confidence, the first link is expectancy to performance, where they have a less confidence that to achieve their desired level of the performance, and they are less motivated by the outcome which they are getting on the basis of their performance. And if they perceive that there is an inequity in the organization, or there is, or if they have set a very difficult goals, that kind of impossible goals in the organization which are not achievable, and the work is generally boring for them, then they are less motivated in the organization. That is a summary about why are some employees more motivated than others. So why, how important is motivation? Strongest performance effect is self-efficacy. That means competence. People who feel a sense of internal self-confidence tend to outperform those who doubt their capabilities. That means the people who are highly confident, they are also performing well in the organization or in their assignment as well. Difficult goals are the second most powerful motivating force. And the motivational force created by high levels of valence, instrumentality, and expectancy is the next most powerful motivational variable for task performance. Perception of equity have a somewhat weaker effect on the task performance. So the most strongest is the self-efficacy, then the difficult goals, and then the importance of outcomes and how that performance link with the instrumentality. So motivation has the strong positive effect on job performance, and less is known about the effects of motivation on the organizational commitment. However, equity has a moderate positive effect. People who have experienced high level of the equity tend to have a high level of effective commitment.